नमस्ते जी वेंस, आई एम डॉक्टर अजीज मोहम्मद खान फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड एंड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर न्यूट्रिशन साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक फिल्ट्रेशन एंड द सब्जेक्ट नेम इज डाउनस्ट्रीम प्रोसेसिंग। इन दिस टॉपिक we are going to discuss about the solid liquid separation. So for the solid and liquid separation, two techniques are used. The first one is filtration and the second one is centrifugation. So what the techniques are mostly used? Flotation, flocculation and filtration, which are the techniques which are used for the separation of solid and liquid separation, in which we will discuss about the filtration and centrifugation. And in this topic we are going to discuss about the filtration. So what is the filtration? Filtration is a mechanical method in which solid particles are separated from the liquid, and the separation is conducted using a porous membrane through which only the fluid will pass and the solid, which are larger in size, will remain on the upper side. In this diagram we can see here the solid particles are in the upper part, they are not filtered, and the liquid part which are smaller in size are filtered through the membrane. And so we can separate the solid particles through the process of filtration. When the solid particles are separated using the process, they take a form of a cake, okay, and all the solid particles from the feed are stopped by a cake, and the cake grows on the rate of which the particles are brought to this surface. So but the factor which are essential for the filtration, the first is size and shape of the solid particles. They are larger in size. If the particles are larger in size, they cannot pass through the membrane and they will not move through the membrane, so they can be separated. Similarly, if their shape is different, okay, suppose that their size is enough to pass, but if their shape is longer, okay, if they are elongated in their shape, then they cannot pass, okay. So size and shape have important role in the separation. Similarly, solid and liquid ratio is also important for the separation. Suppose the liquid ratio is lower and the solid ratio is larger, then only the liquid will pass and most of the solid will not pass from the solution. And scale of operation, what are you using? What is the method of separation? It also varies important, and the aseptic techniques are also important, such as what the separation membranes we are using, which types of filters we are using, which are the very important causative for the separation. And the points to be remembered for selection of filter media: the first one is ability to build the solid, the minimum resistance to flow the filtrate, resistance to chemical attack, minimum cost, and long life. If these criteria are followed, then the filtration method is very important and it is the most suitable. Okay. They may be long life, they must have no lower cost, and they must not have any kind of chemical decomposition to the particles, so that our solution which we are separating must not damage due to the chemical attack. Some more basic requirements are also there. The first is mechanical support, flow access, and provision for remaining excess filter cake. In some instances, washing of filter cake to remove traces of the solution may be necessary. Sometimes the pressure can be given for the separation because if the particle size of the filter and the particle size of the material is same, suppose, then we can apply the pressure for the separation. So different types of filtration are used, which include the depth filter, which are composed of filamentous matrix, and the particles in depth filter are trapped in the matrix and fluid will pass. These are the simple filters. Okay, the absolute filter are the specific filters which have the specific pore size, and the particles which come in the range of the pore size will pass, but the particles which are larger in size cannot pass through the membrane. Okay, most of these absolute filters are used for the separation of bacteria. The next is rotary and vacuum filter. These are the rotating drum, and these drum will rotate, and when they will rotate, they form, they collect all the solid particles which create the cake of the solids, and when the cake is formed of the solids, then the remaining liquid particles will be separated. The next is membrane filters, which we will discuss in another video. Now different types of techniques which are used in the filtration. The first is plate and filter, flame filter press. In the plate and filter plate method, a cloth, there are some plates, okay, in the filter method, there are some plates, and a cloth is placed on the plates, and this plate will help the cloth for support, and when the particles are applied and the sample is applied for the separation, the large particles will remain in the upside, and the smaller particles will pass through the clothes because they have smaller size, and the plates with their filter clothes may be horizontal, but they are more usually hung vertically with the number of plates operated in parallel to give sufficient area. In this plate and sub filter press, we must remember one thing, that when we add some particles or sample, then at the starting filtration is very fast. Okay, the filtration is very fast, but when we take, it will take some time, then there is a large number of solid particles will settle, and this will create some cake. Okay, all the solid particles will settle together and will form a cake. After forming a cake of the solid particles, it will take a long time for the separation. So what we will do, we can apply pressure. Okay, we can apply pressure to the cloth, and we can use the vacuum for the separation, because if there is a formation of cake, then we cannot separate the particles in high speed. Okay, so we can use pressure and we can use the vacuum for the separation. Another thing is that if a cake is formed after separation, then we can remove the solid particles so that the process will start at the beginning, and the process will be very faster than the normal process. So for this we can understand here in a diagram. Suppose this is the filter, and these are the solid particles at the starting. Okay, they are the solid particles which are at the starting. These are the solid particles at the starting. They are spreaded. So at the starting, the separation will be fast. Okay, separation will be fast, but after some times, after some time, what happens? These solid particles will settle down and they will create a cake here. They will settle down here, and after settling in the surface, they will form a cake. Okay, they will form a cake, and after forming this cake, the separation will take longer. Okay, it will take longer time. So what we can do, we can apply pressure for the separation, or we can use the vacuum pressure for separation. The one more thing is that we can remove this cake so that the separation will be started as normal. Okay, so these are the options for the fast separation, and the filtration can be done under pressure or vacuum. This is the diagram of a plate method, plate and frame method, in which there are some plates on which a cloth is applied, okay, for the separation. And when the compression is rotated, all the solid particles will be settled down in a single stage, and the particles which are smaller in size, which are liquid, will be separated and they will be come out. This is the diagram, and these are the filter cloths which are used for the separation. The next is rotary filters. So what are the rotary filters? Rotary filters are the filters which allow to flow the particles through a rotating cylindrical cloth, okay, in which the cylindrical rotation is conducted. So it is just like a cylinder, and the rotation is in the cylindrical mode. And when it is rotated, the large particles will settle down in this portion, and the small particles will be in the upper part, which will be separated. We can also apply the pressure and vacuum for the separation if the cake is formed. The next is centrifugal filters. In this type of filtration, centrifugal force is applied for the separation of particles. And these machines are really centrifuges fitted with the perforating ball that may be allow filter cloth on it. In this method, liquid is fed into the interior of the ball, and under the centrifugal force, all the particles will pass out according to their sedimentation. So these are the diagrams the filter plate method. It is the rotating vacuum filter, and this is the diagram of centrifugal filters in which centrifugal field force is applied, and when the tubes in which the sample is loaded will move, and all the solid particles will settle down here, and the remaining particles which are smaller in size will be in this portion. Okay, these are the liquid part and these are the solid part. Okay, similar here, these are the liquid parts and these are the solid parts which will be settled down in the corner. It will be settled down in the corner, and the remaining particles which are liquid, which are supernatant, will be settled down here. So we can separate the liquid and solid particles through this type of centrifugal filter. The next is cross flow filter. In this method, the feed means the sample is flow. Sample is driven within the filter in downward spiraling direction. When the flow is parallel to filter place, it is being pressurized again to filter to obtain the filtrate. So in this method, we apply a feed, and when the area of these cross flow is equal to each other, then the particles will, which are larger in size, will remain in the upper side, and the particles which are smaller, means the liquid parts, will be allowed by the membrane, and these particles which are liquid in state will be moved through the membrane and they will be separated, but the solid particles will be in the upper part of the membrane and they cannot be separated, they cannot be moved. So this is the method of separation. This is the filter cake, and all the solid particles will be make a cake, and the remaining liquid particles will be separated and filtered. So our topic is over here. In the upcoming lecture, we will discuss about the centrifugal separation. Thank you.